Federal fish regulators in British Columbia are still absorbing the impact tonight of 21,000 Atlantic salmon infiltrating the space of wild salmon native to the West Coast. The farmed fish pose a risk to the regional ecosystem. And as CTV's BC Bureau Chief Melanie Nagy reports, there's a plan underway to round up the invaders.
In Pacific waters off BC's coast, the hunt is on for Atlantic salmon. 21,000 spilled into the open ocean after an electrical fire caused their pen to collapse. While it's an economic loss to the farm, it's also being called a threat to the environment. Atlantic salmon are considered an invasive species on the West Coast. First Nations and environmentalists fear the escaped fish will compete with wild salmon for food and habitat. They also worry they could spread disease.
The wild salmon are in deep trouble, most runs in this province, and I don't think anybody questions that.
All along the coast, the number of wild salmon have sharply declined. This year, Fisheries and Oceans forecasted a return of 4.7 million salmon to one of BC's major rivers. However, only 600,000 showed up. That's about 13% of the original estimate. Advocates say one way to protect wild salmon is to remove farms from the ocean.
The best way to produce farmed salmon, that's in a closed containment system on land.
In 2017, farmed salmon also escaped in Washington waters, prompting state lawmakers to pass legislation phasing out all farming of non-native fish. As for Canada, the federal government is looking to transition the industry to land by 2025.
I don't see any environmental danger.
Hugh Mitchell, a marine veterinarian, opposes land-based farms. He says there's little evidence farmed salmon hurt wild populations. As for the escaped fish,
they don't know how to find rivers and reproduce. They get eaten by predators or they die of starvation.
The fish farm has apologized for the accident and is now working on a plan to recapture the salmon. Melanie Nagy, CTV News, Vancouver.